Hello everyone, my name is Rohit and welcome back to another video on Next.js. In this video, we will integrate Firebase with Next.js. We will also fetch data from Firestore database. Feel free to comment here if you face any issues. You can also DM me on my social media handles. The links are below in the description. So without any further delay, let's get started. I started a Next.js app and these are my default settings for this project. My Next.js project name is Next Firebase. Next, I navigate to the Next Firebase directory in the terminal window. Here we install the Firebase package using the command npm install firebase. Next, I opened the app in Visual Studio Code, but before writing any code, let's run this project using the command npm run dev. Okay, this is the default rendering of the Next.js app. But before writing the code, I am going to set up our Firebase account. For this, search for Firebase and click on the link. You just have to follow the video to set up a Firebase account for the web. The Firebase developer team has made this really easy for us. Now click on web, give your application a name. To connect our Next.js app, we have to use the Firebase config code in our project. To do this, head over to the app directory and create file named firebaseconfig.js. Copy and paste the Firebase config code into the firebaseconfig.js file. We are not going to use Firebase Analytics, so remove the Firebase Analytics code lines. In the build section, click on Firestore database. Click on create database. If you are developing your app for production, read the rules. For now, I am just testing the app, so I will select the test mode. Select the Firestore database location. I am from India, so I will select Mumbai. Wait for a few seconds and your database will be ready. We are going to use Firestore, so inside the firebaseconfig.js file, import the Firestore database and add it to our project. A few moments ago, we saw the default rendering of the Next.js app. These code lines are the reason behind that, but we are going to delete this code because our goal is to fetch and render data from the Firestore database. Here I am going to add a header first. The first line of the code says use client. This is a directive that tells Next.js to run this code on the client side, not on the server side. Next.js import all the required components and objects. Next, we define an async function called fetch data from Firestore. This function will do the actual work of fetching data from Firestore. Inside this function, we use the getDocs function and pass it the collection function with two arguments, DB and users. This means we want to get all the documents from the user's collection in our Firestore database. The getDocs function returns a promise which we await. The promise resolves to a query snapshot object which contains information about the documents in the collection. We then create an empty array called data. We will use this array to store the data we get from Firestore. We use the forFetch method on the query snapshot object to loop through each document in the collection. For each document, we push an object to the data array. The object has two properties, id and doc.data. The id property is the unique identifier of the document, which we get from doc.id. The doc.data property is a spread operator that copies all the fields and values from the document data in the object. After we finish looping through all the documents, we return the data array from the function. Inside home component, we use the useState hook to create a state variable called userData and a setter function called setUserData. We initialize userData with an empty array. We also use the useState hook to run some code when the component mounts. The useEffect hook takes two arguments, a callback function and an array of dependencies. The callback function is where we fetch data from Firestore and update our state variable. The array of dependencies is empty, which means we only want to run this code once when the component mounts, not every time it re-renders. Inside the callback function, we define another async function called fetchData. This function calls our fetch data from Firestore function and awaits its result. Then it uses setUserData function to update our state variable with the data we get from Firestore. We call this fetch data function inside our callback function. Finally, we return some JSX code that renders our web page. We use Tailwind CSS classes to style our elements. We have a div element that contains our user data. We use the map method on our user data array to loop through each user object and render some elements for each users. For each users, we have another div element with a key attribute that is equal to user.id. This helps React identify each user and optimize re-rendering. Inside the div element, we have three paragraph elements that displays user.name, user.age, and user.bio respectively. We use some Tailwind CSS classes to make our user.name bold and large, and user.age and user.bio normal. And that's it. That's how you fetch data from Firestore database and display it on web using React and Next.js. I hope you learned something new today. If you like this video, then give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more content like this. Thanks for watching and see you soon in the next Next.js video.